Right, well, not too happy. Got the Wolseley out. It started smoking like hell. Not sure what that's all about. Never used to. Now the pump's knocking. I'm going to stop it in a moment and find out why. Afternoon, folks. Little job to do on the Stuart pump today. In fact, pretty much a total strip down. I got it out for a run with the Wolseley WD2 last night after work, and they say these things happen in threes. I mean, first of all, I start with the pump. It was knocking quite badly, and the big end bearing on these looks like this. A4 pump, which this is. They got a split in, so they're easily pressed in, apparently. So we'll try and fit that, but it does mean pretty much stripping the pump completely. I think I can do it on the trolley, so that might make things easier, make it easier to work on. But yeah, you might just be able to hear it. Doesn't sound like much, but when it's running, there's quite a bit of load on the piston. So that will make it knock if there's any small amount of wear. So I've got to strip that down. WD2 under there, I had that out, and that's for some reason now started smoking very, very heavily. I'm wondering if in the 3 or 4 months it's been set, one of the piston rings is perhaps seized up. Seems unlikely, but it could be quite possible. So I think I'll pull the piston out of that and have a look. Carburetor's also not quite right, I think. I just can't get it running sweetly. It misfires all the time, like it did when I first had it, and I can't remember what I did. I'm pretty sure I just raised the float height, tried all sorts, and it just won't have it. So under the sheets in that corner is the WD8 on the milking machine, so I might take the carb off and see if that's the problem. You know, I can swap them over just for a test run. Anyway, we're looking at the Stuart pump right now. Well, I've got the piston and cylinder assembly removed. First, just removed a wheel off the pump so I could get the floor wheel off. Remove the complete bearing housing with it. If you remove the bearing retaining bolt on the crank pin, you can just pull that out of the connecting rod. So what I'm going to do now, rather than trying to work with it in this great lump of cast iron, I'm going to get the circlip pliers, remove the gudgeon pin there, and then just work on the little connecting rod. So just for the records, the little oil hole there faces downward. Okay, well, I've got the old bearing out. In the end, I split it just there to weaken it. I needn't have, because these are actually split bearings, but what had happened, it rusted into the connecting rod. Well, I've cleaned that up now. So the new one will press in nicely. You can still see a few marks there. But anyway, weakened it a bit and it came out quite easy. Now I heated up the connecting rod with the gas torch as well. Not too much, just a little bit, which got a bit of oil bubbling around it. Got it out easy. So the next job is just to press that in, and we can start putting it all back together. Okay, well, the bearing's now a good fit. It's pretty tight, but I'm just going to rotate it a bit by hand. It's got some light oil, and that'll bed it in a bit. Once it's freed up a little bit more, then I'll put the pump back together, and hopefully it'll run in quite nicely. Probably won't take all that long, but yeah, it shouldn't knock now. Well, in the end, I couldn't actually get the connecting rod on the lathe because there's not enough swing. Yeah, I could have put it on the faceplate, but such a small amount to take off, I thought in the end it'd be easier just to polish out. So I've managed to polish the bearing enough to get it to fit quite well. So it should just slide on now. That is a pretty close fit. So it's not too tight, but just going to need a little bit of running in. So I'm going to put the pump back together, probably use a bit of gasket seal, I just use a bit of well seal on it this time, and be a little less leaky. Wasn't too bad, but it had one or two oil leaks, which were a bit of a pain. As for the little end bearing, that's in really good shape, so we'll just clean that up. I'll wash this out, make sure there's no dirt in it, and we'll get it all back. Well, the pump's back together now, so I'm going to have a look at the Wolseley, see if I can work out why it's smoking so much. Filled up with oil. No knocks now. As always, I say these things go in threes, so first of all, the other day, it's a puddle of oil under this one. The thread stripped on the filler cap here. That's off a Petter A1 by the look of it, and someone's just jammed that in there. It's the wrong thread. So I knew it was going to go at some point, but it was okay. Anyway, the thread finally let go, so hence the great puddle of oil underneath. Bits come out. Had a number of offers, someone in France, somebody's going over to the Nieuwenen Rally in Holland. Can have a look for me, so hopefully we'll be able to find something. If not, another enthusiast has offered to make me one, which is the same thread, funnily enough, as this. Not sure what it is. It's about 32mm across, bill metric threads, being a French engine. Anyway, so that was that went wrong. And then I got the Wolseley out last weekend, I think it was, and it was smoking like a train, really, really bad. It hasn't run for about 4 months, so I don't know whether a piston ring seized or what. It's possible it could have happened. Anyway, I've got to pull the head off it and have a look. So I suppose I've got to remove the fuel pipe. I'll try and leave the fuel tank in place if I can. Just drain it down a bit. I've got to remove the head bolts, and then to pull the piston out, crankcase door is going to need to come off, and I'll get it the big end bolts. Lovely engine this one, so it'll be nice to see it running well again. Right, see if we can get these head bolts undone. Wasn't too bad. You can see that's really been burning oil. Well, that's really been burning oil, as you can see. It's really coked up around the valves. See what we've got in the way of piston slap. I have earthed the HT lead, by the way, so there's no danger to the mag. Valve guides aren't too bad. So I don't think it's coming from there. Seem worse though. Let's have a look at the cylinder, which looks really good from what I can see, but just oily, so I think it might be worth pulling the piston out and just cleaning up the bore. It's possible that because you can see there's some little gritty bits of carbon, and I'm wondering if perhaps some of those have got around the piston rings and just causing a problem there. So I think we'll pull the piston and see what it's like. Lots of carbon around the rings. I think that's our problem. Oh dear. Here you go. And it hasn't just pulled it out, all that out on taking the piston out. So I think it's time for a decoat. Bearings look good though. Nothing in the little end, so that's good. Right, we've cleaned up the piston, got any carbon out of the grooves, checked the oil holes, they're all clear, which they are, and the oil ring itself is now nice and clean. Oil scraper, as are the compression rings, they're nice and clean as well. Now I think this is going to be a recurring problem with this engine. Perhaps every few years I'm going to have to do this. Obviously, showing an engine like this, you don't do half the running it would do during its working life. But anyway, what you can see, well, hopefully you can see it. Let's try over here, see if it'll focus in. Don't know if you can just see a slight roughness around the top of the piston. Top of the piston, yeah. It's got very strange scoring. It looks like it's been picking up carbon at some stage. I remember when Nigel restored this engine, I think I saw in the pictures those marks, so that's not new. And the same with that on the piston skirt. It's very strange. But I wonder if that's causing it to pick up a bit of carbon. It's just because the top of the piston's worn, it's getting down to the rings, and then I wonder if that was what's causing it to smoke. I've cleaned up the valves. I'm not going to grind them in, as they're in, the seats are in really good condition. Just lightly hone the bore, and it's come up quite well. So I've got to put the rings back on, drop the piston in, but first I'm going to check the ring gaps. Okay, so we're just going to try and check the gap on the compression rings. We just set that in the bore and get hold of the piston and use that just to push it down into the working part of the bore. It's about there, should do. I can see that one's got a massive gap. I think they reckon the rule of thumb is about, well, some people say it's 2 thou per inch of the bore, some people say 4. I'm not sure it's even worth measuring that. I haven't got a feeler gauge that thick. So I think what I'll do is take some measurements of the rings and get some new ones ordered. Right, well, I've measured up the piston and the ring grooves and written down the sizes. So if you need new rings for a WD2 with a 3-inch bore, there it is. I'll probably go to Cox & Turner, my favourite firm who make piston rings. Had a few sets off them in the past and they've always given a great service. Okay, I'm going to stick the piston back in, put the engine back together, see if the decoke's helped.
I don't want another engine lying around in bits, so it keeps everything together.
Just a little bit of oil on the piston, don't want too much. Then some people say you should stagger the ring grooves. Personally, I don't think it makes any difference. I think someone proved that they do rotate whilst the engine's running, but even so, it's probably not a bad idea.
Here's where the fun begins. As they're old worn piston rings, they should probably go in fairly easy, without a ring compressor or anything like that. Lift that up a bit, it's got hold of my glove. That's it. That's got it.
So now we just have to line up the big end, tighten up the bolts, job done. Wolseley's going okay, better than it was, and we've lost the smoke, but I still think it needs new rings. But you see what I mean about it not running quite right, it's misfiring every now and then, which it never used to do. And just occasionally it will start to run really rough, you play about with your choke and then it runs fine again. It's very strange, can't work it out. So the next thing I think I'm going to try is taking the carburetor off the WD8 and put that on it. But not today. The pump's going okay, but it's got another knock from somewhere, substantially reduced the amount of noise it was making, so the big end had obviously gone, but I can't work out what the other noise is. I wonder if it could be one of the valves making a noise. You know, it's not too bad and it seems to be working, so I'll leave it alone for now. So there you go, next step is to get the new piston rings, and then we'll play about with the carb, see if we can improve things there.